So, ladies and gentlemen, you'll hear me talking into this microphone. I just have to say this, but there's no amplification of my voice. So the reason for that is our program is being live streamed. So I'm talking into the microphone for the purpose of the live stream, but you'll be like, well, he's talking on the microphone. I can't hear his voice any louder. So I'm going to talk loud, right? But at the same time, so just so that you're aware, this is not some kind of intentional thing. We just want to remind everyone as you find your seats, first of all, thank you so much for coming. Secondly, please set your cellular devices to a mode that will not interrupt the performance or distract yourself or others during the program. So why don't you take just a moment to do that. So now that everyone's done that, we'll expect silence the entire, no, I'm kidding. If something happens, it's okay. It's all right. So we want to welcome everyone to Beyond Lyrics and Melodies, and now we'd like to introduce our performers, Misaki Harris and Stephen Tunstall. Thank you. So once again, everyone, welcome to Beyond Lyrics and Melodies. Tonight, what we're going to do is take you on a little trip around the world, right? And we're going to stop in France, Italy, Spain, and Japan. And our goal is to translate classical melodies and lyrics into a personable, relatable experience for everyone. So what you just heard tonight first was Prelude number 1 in E minor by Heitor Villa-Lobos, played by Stephen Tunstall on guitar. Now, Villa-Lobos was Brazilian, but did you hear how his music was influenced by folk music, European, indigenous, Portuguese, Dutch, Moorish, African traditions and customs of his hometown? So as we go through our journey, our hope is that you enjoy the music, also that you learn something new, and that you see classical music in a whole new light. So we'll move on to our first part of the program, to our first vocal piece of the program. But before we do, here are just a few reminders for everyone here in person. Firstly, please try to remain seated during the program so as not to distract the performers or other persons. Also, please be respectful, right? An aspect of artistry is vulnerability. You're sharing yourself with other people. So as these artists share their craft with you, your respectful silence during the piece as well as respectful applause afterwards is tremendously appreciated. Also, please be sure that your cellular device is set to a mode that will not disturb yourself or others during the performance. And so that you know, Jaton Park is a tobacco-free park, and that means smoking, vaping is prohibited both inside and outside of the facility. And lastly, there is no alcohol allowed outside of the doors of this facility. So we have a license, but if we violate it, then your donation is going to be significantly higher than you anticipated this evening. So what we're going to do now is go to Italy. Our next piece will feature Misaki Harris as a young boy. Now the piece is called Non so più cosa son cosa faccio, and it's from the opera Marriage of Figaro by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. The song is sung by Cherubino, who's a 15 or 16 year old boy. Now in operas, boys are often sung by female voices, and the goal is to showcase the youth of the character. Now, Cherubino is at the peak of puberty. He starts off the song saying, "I don't even know who I am and what I'm doing." He is distressed, but at the same time confused, and these emotions quickly switch from pleasure to joy to loneliness. Now, Cherubino has been described as the embodiment of love in its purest, most vulnerable, and spontaneous form. He exults in its highs and lows. Now, some of you might be able to relate to his personality, while others perhaps wished you could recognize and accept rapidly changing emotions of youth in your own life as Cherubino does. So, as you listen, look for those emotions and those feelings. Here's Misaki Harris singing Cherubino from Non so più cosa son cosa faccio from the opera Marriage of Figaro.
Ogni donna mangiare di colore, ogni donna mi fa palpitar, ogni donna mi fa palpitar, ogni donna mi fa palpitar. Solo ai nomi d'amore del letto mi si turba, mi saldere il petto, e a parlare mi sforza d'amore.
Sonne
Next, we're going to travel a few hundred miles west to Spain with the piece Andaluza from the Spanish dances by Enrique Granados. Now, these 12 dances were originally written for piano, and they were intended to be vignettes of Spanish life. And each dance borrows rhythms and melodies from all over Spain. And as you have no doubt guessed, Andaluza is from the region of Andalusia in Spain. So Granados himself said, "My inspiration is founded above all in the singing of the people." So see if you can hear the singing of the Andalusian people as Stephen Tunstall plays Spanish dance number 5, Andaluza.
Thank you.
So now we're going to travel from Spain to France. And as we do, I'd like you to picture the following scene. It's a sunset time, and the river has turned pink. A warm breeze ripples across the fields of wheat. A plea for happiness seems to rise out of all things, and it climbs up toward your troubled heart. A plea to savor the gift of life while we are still young, and this beautiful evening is in front of us. For we all pass away, just like that river, the river into the sea, and we to the tomb. Now these are the opening words of our next piece, Bonsoir, by Claude Debussy. Now this piece is the essence of why our artists create music. It's not merely impressive technical skills or glass-shattering volume, right? It's a story painted with the brush of a melody. Can you relate to a time when you are experiencing something absolutely beautiful, but somehow you feel sorrow? Maybe it's because you're grieving about a loved one's passing or the heartbreaking conditions we see sometimes in the world. Yet nature always reminds us to appreciate each moment, take one day at a time, and focus on hope. Let's enjoy Misaki Harris, accompanied by Stephen Tunstall, performing Bonsoir, transcribed by Manaka Matsumoto. So we're partway through our performance this evening. We're gonna have a brief 15-minute break, and then we'll continue. Before our break, we just want to let everyone know how much we appreciate your support this evening, whether in person or on, it's not Zoom, it's actually YouTube, but online, sorry. So if you would like to express your appreciation for these local artists, as well as support future concerts and recitals, please feel free to follow the instructions on the back of your program for those who are in person, or you can donate in cash or anything like that in the box there in the back. So enjoy the intermission. Thank you.
Thank you.
who I had a bunch of stuff written about everyone taking their seats and being quiet, and it's like, wow, this is fantastic. It's unbelievable. So we're going to continue our travels this evening to Spain, where we'll dwell for just a short time. We'd like to reintroduce our artists, Stephen Tunstall and Misaki Harris. So our next piece is very special. It is probably the most popular piece ever written for guitar, De Cuerdos de la Alhambra by Spanish composer Francisco Tárrega. Now, the reason for its popularity is the precision of the technique that is required to play it. Now, it was originally written after a visit to the Alhambra Palace and Fortress Complex in Granada, in Spain. Now, Recuerdos features very challenging tremolo technique, and the idea was to capture the sound of the water fountains at the castle. Now, Tárrega gave this piece as a gift, and he said, "Since I cannot offer a present of any worth, accept this humble poetic impression made on my soul by the grandiose marvel of the Alhambra we both admire. Enjoy the enchantment of Recuerdos de la Alhambra, performed by Stephen Tunstall." So we'll now continue in Spain for a cycle of traditional Spanish songs taken from different regions of Spain. Siete Canciones Populares Españolas is by Manuel de Falla. And tonight's performance is going to be unique because the voice is going to be accompanied by guitar, of course, instead of piano. Now, Spanish folk songs are traditionally accompanied by guitar, so you'll be able to experience the authenticity of the rhythms and emotions that they intended when they originally composed it. Now, De Falla himself said, The spirit is more important than the letter. The essential features of these songs are rhythm, tonality, and melodic intervals. So tonight we'll listen to 5 of the 7 songs, and I'll introduce each song with a brief description. The first is El Paño Moruno from Murcia in southeastern Spain. Now, Murcia is an area that many of you tennis fans will have known, right? Because world number one, Carlos Alcaraz from Murcia. I'm the only tennis fan here. So the story is simple. The story is very simple. A shop reduces the price of a fine cloth because it is stained. So the singer's last line on the word ay, with softening and increasing volume, genuinely conveys the lament for the diminished value of the cloth. So from 7 Canciones Populares Españolas, let's listen to El Paño Moruno, sung by Misaki Harris, accompanied by Stephen Tunstall. Next, we're going to hear Asturiana from a folk song of the Asturias in northern Spain. Now, as you listen, I'd like to like you to imagine taking a quiet early morning walk along a greenway or a trail. The air is a bit cool. There's a light rain, but you carry with you a deep pain in your heart. This is the story of a delicate pine tree sympathetically crying along with the singer. The song says, "To see if it might comfort me, I went up to a green pine tree. Seeing me weep, the pine tree wept, and the pine, how green it was." As you listen, look for the light rain sounds in the accompaniment and imagine yourself seeking acceptance and comfort from nature. Enjoy Asturiana.
Thank you.
Our next piece is Canción, which, surprisingly, is not from a particular region of Spain, but is based on a melody known throughout the country. Now, it's a story about love, loss, and betrayal. Now, instead of being dejected, the backstabbed lover moves on. Now, in the midst of an uplifted key and rhythm, listen for a slight glimpse of jilted anger. Let's listen to Canción. So we now return to Andalusia for our next song, a lullaby called Nana. This very lullaby is the one that Defaya himself heard from his mother when he was a child. It begins with intimacy between the mother and the baby, feelings of love and nurturing. But as it enters the second verse, the mother's fears rise to the surface, perhaps a fear for the child's future or a desperate prayer for her safety. Now, despite these concerns, the mother gradually steadies herself, refocusing on her beautiful, innocent child with reassurance. Let's enjoy Nana. We've come now to the last song of this cycle called Polo. Now, this song also has roots in Andalusia. The accompaniment is reminiscent of a Spanish dance rich in flamenco rhythms and foot stomping. Please hold the foot stomping, right? So now this song is about the wrenching expressions of a broken heart that cannot find liberation but through emotional outbursts, screaming its head off. Now these expressions are executed through fast-moving melodies, or melismas in Spanish. Now this piece is very special for Misaki because expressing burning anger or deep lament was not part of her culture necessarily. But through this piece, she has found a medium to express herself, her deep anger, and be true to her feelings. So as you listen to Polo, please pray for Misaki's husband. You're enjoying our multi-stop burning anger visit to Spain. But we have one more piece before we get on a very long flight. Our next stop is Granada by Spanish composer Isaac Albeniz. Now this is our final solo guitar piece featuring Stephen Tunstall on guitar. Now the piece was originally written for piano, but has become one of the most important works of the classical guitar repertoire since its transcription. Now this piece is from a group of tone poems from different geographical regions of Spain called Suite Española, and was written originally to honor the Queen of Spain. Now Granada was one of Albeniz's favorite parts of Spain. He once called Granada a land endowed with exquisiteness, cordiality, and love, the treasure of Andalusian music. We hope that you love the music of Granada as much as Albeniz did. Let's enjoy the solo guitar of Stephen Tunstall.
Thank you.
So we've come to our final piece of our concert this evening. Now, to get to our final piece, we're taking the 13-hour flight from Spain to Japan for the piece Karatachi no Hana, The Orange Blossoms. Now, this Japanese art song evokes bittersweet childhood memories related to an orange tree. Now, interestingly, in traditional Japanese poetry like haiku, you have to include an element that refers to a specific season. So in the song, the orange tree is the focus, while time and seasons pass through behind the orange tree in the background. Now, interestingly, both the lyricist as well as the composer of this song grew up in a neighborhood with an orange tree that had special memories for each one. So as you listen, try to think of something that brings back a childhood memory to your mind, a favorite pet, a family vacation spot, your mom's freshly baked cookies, and allow those memories to flow through your mind as you enjoy Karatachi no Hana, sung by Misaki Harris, accompanied by Stephen Tunstall. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. We hope you enjoyed our performance tonight. Our goal was to expose you to some different forms of music, right? And try to open your mind to a new way of experiencing that music. And even if we accomplish that to a minor degree, it's a roaring success. So we're pleased with that outcome. Thank you for joining us on our short trip around the world. Now, finally, one of our featured performers, Misaki Harris, would like to address the audience.
Thank you very much for, first of all, and foremost, everyone for coming in person and also online from the West Coast, from Japan even, from 6 in the morning. Thank you so much for coming. Your support means a lot, and hopefully we can keep doing something like this. Also, big applause to our artist, Stephen Tunstall. It's wonderful to have another artist to make the music even better and better as we perform. I hope she's okay. Also our biggest supporters, Todd and Lisa, for making this occasion happen, as well as for lastly and most importantly, my husband Brian, for organizing everything. I only had to show up, practice and show up. And just even in this music journey since the pandemic started, it was always been Brian that's been just pushing my back to keep going. So thank you so much, Brian. Honey, he's kind of walking around busy, but thank you very much for coming.
Unfortunately, the vase which held this in the water, that's what you just heard breaking.
I'm so sorry. I meant to mention one more thing. Is special thanks also to my local teachers. She was my former teacher, Diane Thornton.
Okay.
Completely. She got me through a total vocal restructuring. I am over 30 years old, and she was generous enough to invest her time to work on me. Very special thanks.
That was so difficult.
And then she was not here today. She, unfortunately, something came up. But my current teacher, Christina Pierre, for walking us through this whole process. And very, very, very thankful for meeting wonderful teachers like them.
I am so grateful she had the opportunity to move on to Christina. Christina's a beautiful soprano with so much to offer as a teacher. So you will work, you will move forward as you work with this lovely lady whose daughter was ill today, so she could not be here. So this is for you, sweet thing. Okay, I'll find you.
I can finally drink. Thank you.
So once again, thank you everyone for coming. You are welcome to stay and mingle briefly. The snacks and drinks are available until they are gone or 7:30 p.m., whichever comes first. And just one thing, if you could please throw any and all trash that you have into the trash cans around the facility. Do not go into the kitchen. As you know, there is broken glass back there. So last thing is, by 8 p.m., we do have to be out of the building unless you want to rent it again. If you want to, feel free to come to me. I can make that happen for another 5 hours. But thank you again, everyone, for coming. Have a safe trip. Good night.